This is Mr. Carter, and this is our second osmosis experiment in class, which I've not so creatively called Osmosis and Food Coloring. Now, the setup for this experiment is we start with an egg that has had its shell dissolved by soaking it in vinegar overnight. The vinegar dissolves the calcium carbonate, the shell around the egg, so it's left with just kind of a membrane, so it would behave like any animal cell would. We take this egg with just the thin membrane covering it, and we're going to start by calculating its mass. So we stick it in the scale here, and we find that it has a mass of about 93.9 grams. We're then going to write this on this jar, and we're going to put that egg in corn syrup. I've dyed the corn syrup blue so we can just kind of track the movement of liquid into or out of the egg. Now remember, corn syrup is hypertonic, and to say corn syrup is hypertonic is almost an understatement. Corn syrup is incredibly hypertonic because there's no water in it. It's just liquid sugar. It's like if you melted sugar, it would be a liquid like this. I'd now like you to make a hypothesis to predict what will happen to the color and mass of the egg now. So make a hypothesis for what will happen to the mass. Will the mass get bigger? Will the mass get smaller? And make a hypothesis for the color. Will the egg turn blue on the inside? Will it remain kind of egg-colored on the inside? You know, mostly colorless with a little bit of yellow, perhaps. Write those down in your table now. Now it's a day later, let's take a look at our egg that has been soaking in corn syrup for 24 hours. When we pull the egg out, very gently of course, we notice the egg is pretty flaccid. It's shriveled enormously. It looks like it's lost mass, but we'll put it on the scale to confirm that. And the color is kind of bluish, but it's not like a dark blue. So what this looks like to me is there's just a little bit of staining of the outer membrane, and no blue food coloring actually went into the egg. As you can see, our final mass here is 42.6 grams. So go ahead and write that down, and also write down that the color you could say is slightly blue or barely bluish, something like that. Okay, now that we've recorded our data, we're going to continue with this experiment. So what I wanted to see next is if we took this shriveled egg and we put it in a hypotonic solution, such as pure water with just a little bit of food coloring added, we imagine that something's going to happen to this egg. And, you know, I have a specific idea of what that is, but I'm interested in seeing what you think will happen. So we put it in that hypotonic solution, that pure water. We're going to put in some red food coloring this time so that we can see, again, that movement of liquid into or out of the egg. If the red goes into the egg's going to turn red, right? If not, it's going to remain just kind of bluish. So go ahead and make your predictions now. Make a hypothesis again for the final mass. Will it be bigger? Will it be less? And make a hypothesis for the color. Will it be blue? Will it be red? Will it be purple? Will it be pink? Will it remain colorless? You tell me. Thank you. Okay, the egg has been soaking in that distilled water for 24 hours. It's a day later. Let's go ahead and pour out the liquid. And this just helps us remove the egg, right? We want to be very gentle with this egg. Now we can tell just by looking at it that this is a big egg. It looks pretty big, pretty full. Notice the color. The egg is now a really dark, rich red color. It's clearly red on the inside. So that red water has gone into the egg. If you predicted that the egg would get bigger, then your hypothesis appears to be supported. We'll put it on the scale in just a moment and find out if it is. Again, notice that bright red color. You can see the yolk in there. That's the yellow spot. It looks like the final mass of this egg is 89.0 grams, and clearly the egg has gained mass. So again, if that was your prediction, your hypothesis was supported. So let's go ahead and pour this egg out. And in keeping with this experiment, we're going to do something else to it now. Now that we've got a nice full egg, let's put it in a hypertonic solution. So let's do more corn syrup. This time we've got some corn syrup without any food coloring added to it, so it's just kind of a nice golden color naturally. And we're going to predict what happens to this egg next. So we're going to put the lid on it. We're going to leave it for 24 hours. So we've got a nice full egg that's red on the inside, this beautiful red color. We're going to coat it in the corn syrup and leave it in this jar with corn syrup for 24 hours. You can see the egg is full of water. Water is less dense than corn syrup, so the egg kind of floats on top. Go ahead and make a prediction now about what you think will happen to this egg. So again, the egg is nice and full. It's full of water mostly. It's being placed in an extremely hypertonic solution, corn syrup. What's going to happen to the egg? What will happen to the egg's mass? What will happen to the egg's color? Okay, it's another 24 hours later. This egg has been soaking in this corn syrup overnight, so let's take a look. One thing that you'll notice right away before we even take the egg out is there's a layer of red water sitting on top of the golden corn syrup in the jar. This is, of course, because water is less dense. less dense than corn syrup, so it sits on top of the corn syrup. Just like oil is less dense than water, so it sits on top of the oil. So we've got this water. Where did it come from? Well, as you all know, it was inside the egg. That's why the egg now looks shriveled up. Because of osmosis, the egg was hypotonic, the solution was hypertonic, so the water went from the egg into the solution. If we take out the egg, we still notice we have these two layers. The red water came from inside the egg. The golden corn syrup below that was already in the jar, right? So by putting the egg in this jar, we've freed up that water. It's left the egg and gone into the jar. So you might already know what to expect. If water's left the egg, we can expect that the egg's going to have shrunk. And when we look at it, that's clearly the case. You'll notice the egg has lost water. We're going to put it on the scale here in just a moment and measure its mass. But in the meantime, let's look at the color. It's got a bright red color, no different than from when we put it in. What happened was the egg lost water, and some of that water was dyed red, but it didn't actually gain any of the corn syrup, right? The corn syrup isn't going to go into the egg. Okay, we look at this, and we see it has a mass of 39.7 grams. And again, the color is just as bright red as it was before, so there's no change in color. Now let's keep going. We're going to take this egg, and we're going to put it back in a hypotonic solution. So we've got pure water. We're going to add some blue food coloring this time, because this is what I really want to do to see if I can make a more complicated color here using just osmosis, right? So we've got this blue water, extremely hypotonic. We're going to put in this hypertonic egg, right? There's not a lot of water left in the egg. It's mostly just those natural egg solutes. So we're going to stick the egg in there, we're going to put the cap on it, and we're going to leave this overnight. And just like with the rest of our experiment, I'd like you to make a hypothesis now about what you think the mass of the egg will be and what you think the color will be after 24 hours in this blue hypotonic water. Okay, it's 24 hours later. Let's check our results. You can look in the jar, and without removing the egg, we can see the egg has turned this very dark color. We'll take a look at it more closely. We also notice that there's a little bit of red liquid in with the blue liquid. So remember that osmosis sometimes exchanges fluids a little bit. So some of the water might have left the egg and also gone back into the egg. It's not a perfect out or in. Sometimes it's both. But on the whole, it looks like the movement of liquid was into the egg from the solution. And so in keeping with that, it looks to us like the egg has probably gained a little mass. It looks kind of nice and big and full. And on closer inspection, what we have here is a dark, beautiful purple color. So using just osmosis, we were able to actually blend colors inside of the egg. We have a rich purple color inside the egg, very dark. And again, we can see the yolk kind of peeking through the egg. We're going to go ahead and take this egg, and we're going to put it on the scale so you can record the mass. This is the final step in our experiment. And we see that the mass is now 85.5 grams. So it has definitely gained mass. So if that was your hypothesis was supported. And then we'll pop the egg out there. That's our final egg. So at the end of this experiment, we've created this really amazing looking dark purple egg. Now, let's compare and see if the egg really is purple on the inside. So we're going to take a stirring rod here. We're going to pop this egg and compare it to the blue solution. And we see, yes, it is purple. It's not blue. So the reason, of course, for that, well, I'm not going to explain that. You tell me the reason for that. So I'll have you write that in your conclusion. But notice we have a beautiful purple color instead of the blue color. So it was soaking in blue water, but when we pop it, it's actually purple. I hope you enjoyed this experiment. I'm going to have you write your conclusion in just a moment.